process the information as individual units or as a whole. Here we have to process the information, if you want to remember, unless you have the key, because perhaps I might have given this lecture somewhere else also. So here if we try to process these symbols as individual letters, we will be in a soup. We will not be able to remember unless we are like Shakuntala Devi, we have a tremendous memory. We cannot remember. Now the same symbols, next. Yes. Sorry. I have done nothing except putting space in between at certain places. So what has happened? The four, five symbols are transformed into one unit of information. That is decoits, D-A-C-I-O-E-T. Instead of remembering as five alphabets, you remember it as a one word. So 20 different or 30 different units of information have been transformed into 4 or 5 different units of information. You are able to handle it. So that was the rationale behind my advice that use no more than 1 or 2 ideas per sentence. So if you are able to reduce the number of ideas to be used or the number of units of meaning, we call it semantic units. If you are able to reduce the number of units to be handled by our memory, the reader's memory, then it becomes easier for him to understand your writing. And by removing unnecessary words or breaking the strings of nouns, exactly we are doing the same. Next please. Now, the human memory has three components, roughly. First is a sensory register, where whether whatever I am talking you are hearing, or if you are reading whatever alphabets you are going through your eyes, these are sensory units. That register and the duration is quarter of a second. They remain in the sensory register for a quarter of a second. Then they are transferred to a short-term memory component of our brain. The short-term memory component, they remain there for a few seconds. And then, if they are transferred into meaningful components, then they go to long-term memory and the duration is per long. Now, I have been talking in this particular session for last almost 40 minutes. You will not be remembering what sentences I used, what words I used. But many of you will be remembering the overall meaning of what I have been hinting about, what I have been talking about. So your brain has been constantly transforming the sound signals that I have been delivering to a short-term memory to long-term memory. You may not remember the sentences or exact words also, but you will remember the meaning. So this is the basic problem. The problem is in the short-term component of our memory. There are two constraints. Duration is only a few seconds, and it cannot handle more than 6 or 7 different units of information. If the units of information are more than 7, it is confused. That's why you see most of our everyday life we have 7 seas, 7 heavens, 7 colors. Upper limit is almost half of our experience is around 7. If we try to analyze units of information beyond 7, we get confused. So because of this limitation of the shorter memory of our readers, we should not put many ideas or many qualifying words till they are resolved into meaning. For example, the first, again we go back. Let us go back, go back, go back, go back. first sentence, why it was appearing difficult was because the large, light green, circles, blue, hexagon, all these units of information are not related to each other. We have to remember our process, our short memory has to process all these units of information separately. That is 14 or 13 units of information. So, our short memory fails. What happened in the last sentence, 28 words? We would not expect a crumbled piece of wire to suddenly straighten itself. One unit of information. All these words are transformed into one unit of information. But that is exactly what happens. Second unit of information. If the wire is made of certain words, third unit of information. Only three units of information compared to 14 units of information in the first sentence. So that's why the first sentence is difficult. The last sentence is easy to understand. So the inference, the outcome of what I have been saying so far is that we have, as authors, we have to try to help the short memory of our readers by not crowding too many ideas in our writing. And this we can do in two different ways. Number one, the three recommendations I gave, cut out all unnecessary words, because these are unnecessary burden on our short-term memory, they don't serve any useful purpose. Then, hydrolyze the noun links. And third, use more verbs, acting rather than nouns. That is one part. The second part is see to it that in your sentence, more or less, it's not that every sentence, but 90% of the sentences are such that there is one or at the most two ideas per sentence and not many, many more ideas per sentence. If you do these two things, your writing will become more readable, easier to understand. Now, let us come back. That was one part. Now we come to the a very ordinary routine aspect, but an editor noticed that this is one of the most common mistakes among authors. One is the mismatch of subject and verb. This is very common. I do not explain anything. All of you know only. Only thing is you have to be more careful that subject and verb, when they are separated by many interesting words, often the verb and the subject do not match. I will give some examples. Yes, please. Thank you. Next one. Okay, next please. There are a few examples. The dust accumulated on clothing, linen, curtains, etc. contain many bacteria. Now, this contain verb should be singular because the subject here is a dust. So the confusion arises because in between the clothing, linen, curtain, so many other nouns have come. So the author thinks their two plural form should be used. But actually the contain belongs to the subject, that is dust, and it should be contained, not contained. Next. Three injections at intervals of 4-6 months of age, followed by a booster dose again the first year. Ease is not necessary. Three injections is the subject, so are generally recommended. But this, why this mistake has occurred is because between the subject, that is the injections, and the verb, there are too many words and the author is confused. So this problem arises. Next, please. This is one, that is non-agreement of the subject and the verb. This is a common problem in scientific writing. And second problem is the certain shift in the point of view. We observe negative deviations from the idiotinacy blocks if we are used as a solid. Now, we start in subjective mode, that is, we observe. And we then the second part of the sentence, if DI is used as a solvent, we go to the third be eminently feasible to focus on studying on disorders like this while time and resources are available to update and enhance your own knowledge base. Now we start in the third person mode and go in the last part of the sentence in the second person, your own. So this should not happen. Crystallization occurs immediately when benzene ether mixture was added to the food solution. Again, maybe occurs by the present tense and then was added to the past tense. In the same sentence, we have mixed the present and past. So these are minor aspects, but as a writer of an effective communication, you have to see that these little carelessness is avoided and such things are not there. Okay, next. Then absence of parallel structure. I will not go into this because of this requires a rather long time to discuss, because the concept of parallel structure is important in writing, but it will take a lot of time. Next. I have given some examples. If somebody is interested, he can go through examples and he will understand. Next. Then another thing is, many times we confuse between pairs of similar sounding words. We call these homophones. And some of the common examples are between sight and sight, discrete and discrete, loose and loose. Loose and loose is very commonly confused. Sound similar, and while writing we are a little bit careless and we sometimes allow this to be. Next, then again, prescribe, proscribe, illusion, illusion. Here the sound is different, but again the spellings are somewhat similar, so this confusion arises. So please be careful about this confusion. Next. Okay, that it remain. I will end my presentation here because I feel that some of you want to raise some questions. So please, I have some time till now. So some of the questions which you want to raise about my presentations are about some other presentations which you were raising earlier also. Let us frankly discuss some of these. Yes, please. You were saying something. Now we can discuss that.
Study where team center has many contributors.
Yeah.
Like 4-5 centers.
Yeah.
Team center itself is, the study itself is spread over a number of years, and because of that period, long period, number of people have been contributing.
Unfortunately, there are no set guidelines for this, and this type of collaboration is based on mutual understanding between different groups and different authors within the group. So, as editors, they don't have much role in this. The collaborating authors or the collaborating groups, they have to come to an understanding. But roughly, the understanding should be something like this, that the group or the author which started the work or which has the major contribution should be first in the order of precedence, followed by others. But again, that the groups, collaborating groups or the collaborating authors have to decide between themselves. The editors don't have much role in this. Only they depend upon the communicating author. Normally what happens, they receive a paper from a particular author and he is taken as the communicating author. And sometimes they give a star also, author for correspondence and all that. But they are not sure that whether he has the major contribution. He may be communicating because he may be senior there, he may be head of the department or in a superior position. The actual work might have been done by somebody else. So ethics demand the person who has contributed scientifically most, he should be the first author. This may or may not happen in actual practice, but this has to be decided within the collaborating persons.
Sir, I have some other contention to say.
Yes, yes.
See, multi-centric study is for specific purpose. So each center has to publish own write-up, and then the publisher or editor should sum it up in its own way.
No, no, neither the editor do not do this. Only the collaborating centers, they coordinate amongst themselves. And when they have finalized the draft, I mean, whether the part is written at one center, another part is written at another center, but somebody must be coordinating, a senior person must be coordinating. So he combines or integrates the different parts of that particular study. And what editor receives is a finished product. He cannot sit on judgment who has contributed what. He can only judge as to the quality of the communication with the help of course, peers. But he cannot decide upon the exact role or relative contribution of different authors.
What is the concept of corporate authors?
Well, this is a relatively new issue. Corporate author, usually this problem does not arise in primary communications. It may arise in secondary or even at sometimes review type of articles or at other levels. In reports it can arise. But I do not see any specific issue in primary communications. I mean, an author might have been sponsored, his work might have been sponsored by corporate, by giving some funds or something for a particular piece of research. But as far as results are concerned, these are just purely on the scientific merit and not on the basis of funding or any other criteria. Yes, please. You were trying to say something. Yes. Let him speak first. Yes, you.
Me? In the context of language of science, in your earlier lecture,
yeah,
you said, sir, there can be different interpretations in connection with the poem.
Yeah.
Even the poet, he wants the same thing.
Yeah.
And that, I could not get it. How the poet doesn't have the uniform message, or at least uniform theme.
Actually, in poetry also, there are different types of poetry. The poet often wants to be mysterious, appear to be mysterious. And his mystery will be enhanced if the number of interpretations are more. Now, that applies to romantic poets, for example. But there are other poets, for example, in Hindi poetry, Bhakti Kal, the poets of the they don't have such ambitions. For example, if Surdas says something or Tulsidas says something, they have a simple task before them. That is, they want to praise the Lord or they want to describe his life or whatever. They don't have such ambitions. But if you come to the modern poetry, let us say Jaishankar Prasad or Mahadevi, I am talking with reference to Hindi poetry because I am a little bit conversant with Hindi poetry, not with other Indian languages. So if you come to Mahadevi Varma in Chhayawal, now the lines she writes about a particular flower, let us say, about the color, how it looks, she has a particular mood and she interprets in a way that it should look mysterious. And mysterious and alluring, that is one goal of poets. So these poets will be very happy if different meanings are associated with their writing. Yes. No, I didn't follow your question. How will you report data?
Supposing there are...
Basically, the new data, 90% of the times, we report in scientific papers. 90% of the time. And sometimes, 10% we report in departmental reports. These are two major methods of reporting data. So, there is no conflict between the two. In scientific paper writing, of course, you have to report data. Unless data is there, they will not accept your paper at all. As far as reports are concerned, again, the basic consideration of data reporting are similar in the two cases. Authenticity. Of course, there is a separate presentation on data, so I was not talking about this. Otherwise, in my presentation, which you get, there are some slides on data presentation. I have not presented those in the first lecture, but the version you will get in your CD, there are some slides about data presentation. I have explained what are the basic strategies in data presentation, how you should present data, what are the pitfalls in data presentation. Although I have not talked about these issues, but these are there very much in my presentation. But if you have any specific issue about data presentation, we can discuss.
Sir, in most of the cases, we write bibliography.
Yes.
And suppose a person has done himself some work. Is it necessary to write the bibliography or not?
No, it is, usually it depends. If the present work is related to your earlier work, then you must give a reference of bibliography. But if it is not related, then you may not give. That is, the sole criteria of choosing entry in a reference list or in bibliography is whether that particular study is related to the present paper or present communication. If it is related, you give that reference. If it is not related, do not give that. Because there should be some justification. Of course, why do we cite references? We want to support the present study by saying that similar work has been done earlier, or to refute earlier work, or to support earlier work, or get support from earlier work to our present study. These are the basic functions of citing references. So, if these present study and the earlier study is related, then you give reference, otherwise don't give. Now, the criteria for selection of reference. Selection of reference, that's true. So, basically, two, three aspects we have to keep in mind. Number one, the peer should be specialist in the same general area. You cannot send for peer review an article where the referee is a specialist in some other area, general area, and you are sending for some other area. A crystallography paper has to be, of course, sent to a person who is specializing in crystallography and not to a person who is specializing in spectroscopy. However, eminent he may be in academic position, number one. That is, he must be doing active research presently. He might have done 10 years ago, no. Presently, whether he is active in that field. He must be doing active research in the particular area in which communication is received, number one. He should not be related to the person who is submitting paper, related in the sense academically or otherwise, or from the same institute. We should not send to the same institute from where the paper has been received. He should not be a student or his teacher. To avoid bias. Then of course, we should not reveal the name of referee. And third is, we should not depend normally on a single peer review. We should have multiple peer reviews. We should have at least two opinions. So that we can compare the two opinions against each other. We can check whether one is biased or not, or just casual. Sometimes they don't have time, but they do not want to send back the paper because they have some relations with the editor. So they write something, one, two innocent sentences, just that it can be accepted. You must see whether he has given some specific technical comments or not. So these are some a few basic aspects here.
Thank you. I request all the participants.
Great lecture. Also taking much time. I am very feeling hungry. We already are today and we will be here back by 2:30. Again, 2:30 we will start the next session. Please take time.
हमारे यहाँ पर निवास करें अग्नि आदि देवता अपने
from this time to the end of the day, so it might be boring, it might be pleasing also. So this is about the assembling and organizing data. This is determining content, outline building and creating sections and diagrams. Next. So I will be having two sessions. One is part one, so second is part two. Part one is regarding the determining content, outline building. First of all, I will start the part one. Part one is about determining the content. Whatever content you may be having for presentation, presenting an article or writing a research paper or writing a news report or writing a technical article. So, contents might be text, text may be meant, and then there will be different requests if somebody wants to approach you for your research paper, then correspondence. Its content matter is there with you, but you have to put in a systematic manner. So how it will be put, I will describe in detail. First of all, making an outline. Outline will start from the title, then there will be authors, author's affiliation, where they are associated, then there will be abstract, then there will be keywords, then there will be a short title, then introduction, material methods. It will contain its study area, statistical analysis which we have used, then results, discussion, acknowledgement, differences, and different requests. So this is a rough outline of drafting a research article. So types of article. Which type of article you are going to write? It may be a research article, it may be a popular article, it may be a feature article, it may be a technical article, it may be an abstract while you are going to present a paper in a conference. It may be for presenting a poster in a conference, it may be for exhibits or a folder. So, first of all, I will discuss about the research article. Research articles are also of different kinds. There may be editorial, there may be commentaries, there may be review article, there may be original article, there may be correspondence, there may be short notes, and there may be book reviews. And every article has a different style of writing. Next. So, first of all, you should know the writing. Writings are about the features article, which may be fun, language and humor, books and brochures for teaching and education purposes, newsletters, which are particularly in-house bulletin, which carries the information about your organization, then talking points, caption and pages, news releases, and meeting reports. So, there are different kinds of writing products. Writing when and where. There are many different styles. Set certain goals and timeliness. You should set some time that I have to write this article for newspaper. So, newspaper you have to submit very quickly. So, time is very important and stick to that time. Do it now. Write anywhere, jot down thoughts. If you have any thought, just put on the paper and start writing. Get a jump start, write one, two sentences each day. Name a document and now you have draft. Empty page next day. So, you have a draft and you can score next day. Science writing, how? There are many effective strategies. Research, do not let it become recreation. It should be a technical research article, a question of a study in the morning. How you have to refine your article, how you have to refine your language. So that should be very important. Follow the what around you. You must know what is happening around you. So you should be very at least of the recent development, whatever happening in around you, in the world. Stay current, read constantly, read different types of magazine, different types of newspaper, different kinds of journals. Only then you will be aware about the recent developments. And what fishing has to develop a relationship with the topic and what non-scientists know about it. So that is, reading is a must. Next. And why write? All thinking, all textual analysis, all experiments and the data gathering are not anything until we write them up. In the world of psychology, we are what we write. So writing is very important, otherwise whatever you have with you, that is useless. Nobody knows what you are having with you. Unless and until you will not write. So you must write, but you should know how to write in a better way. Why to communicate? Communicate results in periodicals. You can communicate your findings in annual
If you want to write a review article, you can pick up certain articles, around 50-60 articles, and you can write a review article, you can write a book, or you communicate to media. Communication is the process by which any message is given or received through talking, through writing, or through making gestures. There are two kinds of communication. One is verbal communication, one is written communication. Verbal communication is non-verbal communication means that without writing you can communicate through eye, through hand, through some isharas. That is also a communication. And that is a verbal communication when you are talking. And then is a writing-reading communication. So nonetheless, communication is usually described along a few major dimensions. Content, whatever things are going to be communicated, that is the content. Source, from where it is going to be communicated, sender. Form, in which form you are going to communicate. Channel, through which channel, there are different mediums, through which channel you are going to communicate. And then destination, where you are going to communicate. This reporter, who is going to read up. Purpose, for what purpose you are going to write. Next. So this is a component of a communication process. Communication process means this is a source. Okay, fine. This is the source. So who is the source? You are the source. And this is the message. What is you are going to convey? This is the message. Suppose you are going to write an article, the article become a message. Then this is a channel. Channel, if you are going to submit an article in a journal, so that journal becomes a channel. And the receiver, who is going to read. And this is the feedback. How you have written, that will go, comes through a feedback. So this is a channel of communication. Actual writing, logical communication of the endeavor or researchers to communicate their findings to their peers, peer group. For wider dissemination, the new information must appear in a scholarly communication system. You must be knowing well because you are already seniors and you are already working in this area, so you might be aware about the system. A well-written paper reflects clear thinking of the authors. If you have written a very good paper, then definitely you will get appreciated. The referee who was asked to scrutinize the paper is also directed to be reviewed if it is well written. If it is not well written, it will be rejected immediately on the first notice. If it is well written, then he will go further and then he will give good comments. A badly written paper puts the referee off. If the paper lacks clarity, even the work, if it is of a good quality, may be lost. So it is very important that you write a very good paper. It is to be rejected by a wider audience and cited more often. If good paper is cited again and again, so you will receive more citation, then it also helps in your promotion process also. Next. In an extreme case, a badly prepared paper with valid results may get even rejected. So it is very important that the paper should be well written. The scientific quality of a work may not ensure publication of a poorly drafted paper. If you might have done very good research, but if it is not communicated in the best way, then it will get rejection. With over 85% rejection rates for papers submitted for a publication in good journal, badly written paper is stand a poor chance. Now you can understand, if you are going to submit your paper in a very good journal, so unless and until it is not good written, it will be immediately rejected. This is the 85% rejection rate of the very good journals. So if unless and until you have not written good papers, you can understand where your chances stand. Then there are writing style. It should be very simple, simplicity, brevity. The wise author will ensure that message is translated in as few words as possible. This ensures attention and famous mention. Express creativity without weight of English literature imposed itself. Don't complicate your sentences. It should be very simple and brief, clear cut. Most complex scientific concepts can be presented in a very simple manner. Purpose of writing is not only display of data but communication. Avoid single sentences, paragraphs. Paragraphs should not be of one line or two lines. Paragraph means it should contain at least 4-5 lines. It should look like a paragraph. If you are terminating your sentence on two lines, this paragraph is not a paragraph. Avoid single sentence paragraph, define terms when used. If you are defining any abbreviation, for example, WHO, right? World Health Organization, first time. Again, you can use abbreviations, but it should be defined when you are using for the first time, any term, any language. Suppose you are writing AIDS. AIDS is a very common term, but at least at one place in the starting, you define okay, what is AIDS. Then you can use abbreviations. Next. Then there is the writing process. Know the reader. Interpretation. First process is to research, read, spend time to produce final products. First draft stage. It is advisable to have ideas on paper, then work toward improving manuscript in terms of flow, style, clarity, logic and presentation, etc. Use short and simple words instead of long and complex words. Avoid ambiguity. Dr. Sharma was telling which is very important message of your paper. You should highlight that message. Is key finding important enough for publication? What are the important key points to warrant a research paper? Letter to editor, short communication, etc. So you must know whether this type of communication is suitable for a research publication. This is suitable for a letter to editor. This is suitable for a short communication. That should be very clear in your mind where you are going to submit your paper. Is there sufficient new information to merit writing a paper? What kind of paper is justified? It is a full paper, short paper, or a case report? A thorough literature search is must. You should go for the search medline or any other secondary sources and find out what other people have done. Then authorship. All those who have contributed to intellectual content. In the early morning, you were discussing about the authorship. Who should be the author? So who has contributed intellectually? They should be responsible for the authorship and undertaking before paper is considered for publication. Most of the journals, they want to take undertaking of all the authors. Those who have contributed, they should give undertaking. Next. This is a long journey of communicating. Collect all the relevant material. Your scientific data in the form of either tables or figures or charts or supporting documents. You must be having some text. You may be having different types of tables and data. You must be having some graphs and some photographs, pictures, everything. You should put at one place and then arrange these tables. Difference of a research paper. Then start obtaining permission relating to material use. If you have used any material, then start obtaining permission. If there is any picture you are using and that is copyright protected, then you will have to approach the person concerned or the journal to take the copyright permission that I want to produce this, reproduce this picture, or reproduce this article. Then you will have to take some permissions. So start obtaining permissions related to material use. Any unpublished information to use material obtained from others. So you should have, you should collect all these information with you. Next. Then there is a logical sequence. Research question or hypothesis study. Necessity of a present study, why you are going to present this paper, why you are going to write this paper. So there's a necessity of a present study. Evidence is then presented based on the data generated. Whatever data you have, then you have to present that you have done this study. Then credibility of the authors, what they are doing, what they have contributed. Implication of findings are discussed in the light of the available knowledge. What knowledge is available right now? And what your study is going to show. So what extra you are going to put in the present work. And then conclusion and recommendation. Size of the paper is very crucial. Having too many ideas in one paper increases the size and dilutes the crucial message. So if you have very more ideas, then try to divide it into two papers. Don't put each and everything only in one paper. The number of chances of paper acceptance is usually inversely proportional to the size and number of tables and figures. If there is too much of lengthy paper, nobody is going to accept it. So try to reduce it and try to put it in a 3 or 4 pages. Only then the acceptance will increase. There is an international committee of medical journal editors that recommends the IMRAD system. There is an IMRAD system. I will explain to you in next 2-3 slides. What is the IMRAD system? That is the standard format of writing research paper. Begin with a rough outline of a paper. Just make a rough outline. Whatever you have in your mind, just keep on writing and make a rough draft. From tables and figures, sketch briefly a summary of the results. You must be having some tables. So you must be having some figures. So try to write something of text on the results. Summary of the results that you have obtained. One could then write the result section detailing the salient findings. What have been your findings? Then you can write. A few possible tentative titles could be thought of. Then you must think about the title. What should be the title? Because title is very important. Title is something that attracts you. So it should be very crispy, it should be very attractive, it should be very short, not too lengthy, not too complicated typing. Then discussion. Then abstract should be written at the end of the paper. Then you will write abstract. I am going to discuss about the abstract in the second part. So abstract will be written after when you have written your entire paper. Most important is that the format. You are just before you start writing the paper. Without this rough blueprint, the paper may evolve in a different direction. That is why the outline and the draft is necessary, because only then can give you a chance to improve your paper. Most of us need to work like a sculptor who first makes a rough model, then chisels it down to perfection. Because first he creates a model, then it is modified, then put the final picture. Key is to start and make a first draft and then improve on it. In scientific communication, discussion, debate, and criticism add value to writing. If you are writing some paper, you can discuss about your paper.
co-authors and with any other subject experts, that will improve your writing and that will improve the paper also. We are also writing paper, we are sending paper to some expert. Please give your critical view, critical review of the paper. So that improves the paper quality. So that is very important. In typographical error on the first page of introduction or abstract indicate that the author is careless. So you should avoid this type of mistakes. There should not be any typographical mistakes. So because it gives very bad impression that you are not writing very paper, you are very careless, you are not writing paper very good. So you should take notice of this, that this error should not occur. After second draft, share paper with your co-authors. So they will again give some input. Ensure that all tables, figures listed in the text are actually present. And you should be very careful, whatever table and pictures you are going to put, there should be described in text also. Appropriate length, style of the headings and subheadings, that is also very important. The heading should be in boldface, subheading should be in light face or italic. Then policy on the user application in this type of standard deviation as given in any journal. So you should use that deviation whatever being given in the journal. Format of initial citation and bibliography. Whatever references you are going to cite, they should be given in the text also. Suppose if somebody is going to search reference number 1, it should be cited at 1 and it should be given at 1. Suppose there is a difference Kumar et al. And you have marked at 1. If somebody is going to check at 1 and there is no Kumar et al, so it gives a very bad picture. So you should be very careful while you are citing. People usually ignore this feature. They don't bother about the references. That is a very important feature. If you have 10 references, they should come alphabetically. If it is a format style, it is Rankovic style, they will first come, first will be written. There is no alphabetical system. If a reference comes first, it will be written first. And it should match with your text. Index citation in bibliography, instructions on preparation of tables and figures, and other important information including the report for preparing an index. This is written communication, structure of the research paper. Imminent is telling, writing a paper is like relating or writing a story or essay. Story has a beginning, main body, and end. Similarly, a paper has beginning, middle, point, and then end. Sir Austin Bradford Hill, he was a physician in British Medical Research Council. He felt that a research paper should consist of this. Four questions. Number one, why did you start? Why did you start writing the paper? Number one question. Number two question, what did you do? Question number three is, what did you find? And question number four, what does it all mean? So these are the four questions. You should be able to answer this all four questions in your paper. And these questions are next. Structure. When applied to structure of a paper, section corresponding to each of these questions are, number one, introduction. Why did you start your study? So you should be able to define this type in one or two paragraphs. Why you have undertaken this study? What was the purpose of doing this study? What are the aims and objectives? So you can describe in the introduction section. Then there is a method. What did you do? So while you were doing some study, while you carried out your research, so what type of material and methods you have used? What was the study area? You can describe about the study area. You have describe about the chemicals you have used. You can describe about the statistical methods which you have used. You can describe about the ethical community clearance which you have taken. So these all will come in the section methods and material methods. Then there is the results. What did you find? You can describe your results here. Then discussion. What does it all mean? In discussion section, you can discuss your weak and strong point. And you can discuss your results with the earlier studies. So this is the discussion part. Then title, abstract and references. There are also three portions that will come in the sequence. Then in-depth style of writing in biomedical literature. Next. Number one is introduction. It is the beginning of an article. Must be interesting enough to arouse the interest of the reader. Should not contain shocking statements, mainly background and aims, rationale of the study, why the study was undertaken. Not too long and not too short, and avoid extensive review of literature. But it should not contain too much of literature. Just give 3-4 references. Which are very essential, which are utmost required in this section. So that should be ideal structure of your introduction. Next. Then methods. Sometimes it is also called materials and method. Important section as it defines what you did. It should answer the question who, what, when, where and how. Why the study was carried out, where it was carried out and what type of chemicals you used. So all this can be given in this section. Detailed study design, study material, analysis and statistical analysis. ethical triggers and informed consent. Then all will come in this section, method. Next. Then the results. Results see information on all parameters that were evaluated. Then the results can be in three format. They can be text, they can be in the form of tables, they can be in the form of graphics. Important to see that data in the tables and figures are not repeated in the text. You should ensure that the data whichever is given in the tables or figures, it should not be repeated in the text. And the common mistakes include mismatching numbers in text and tables. Suppose you are writing a text and you are giving number something like 68 in and table number 1. But if you are going to see table number 1, 68 is not there, there is 38. So this type of mismatch should not be there. You should make it ensure that whatever is given in the text should match with the tables or in the figures. And result must be factual and unambiguous. There should not be any ambiguity. Then the discussion part. Discussion contains statement of principal finding, what have been your principal findings. Then strength and weakness of the study, what were your strength and what you could not do. So you can describe that because of these reasons, because of problems, you could not continue this study or you could not carry out this type of work. So you can also mention your weakness of the study also in the discussion part. And comparison in between other studies, whatever has been done in the past, what other people have do, what is why your study is different from the others. So that can be discussed in the comparison with the relation of other studies, meaning of the study, unanswered question and future research. If you want to give some ideas, some policy decision, so you can put some your ideas, how beneficial is your study for the others, for the policy makers. And unanswered question and future research, avoid claiming to be first person to have done the work or first study in the world. You should not write this type of sentence that I am the first person to carry out this type of study, that this is the first study in the world. So this type of sentences should not come in this section. And then conclusion. 4-5 lines or one paragraph is sufficient for conclusion. Next. Then there will be acknowledgement. As per the ICMJE guidelines, all those who have helped in the work at some stage but have not qualified for authorship may be included in such as support from the chief of the department. He may not be involved in your study, but he is giving you some help, every kind of help he is providing you, he is giving you support, so you can mention his name in support from the other department. Financial material, you are getting some financial help from Department of Science and Technology, from CSIR, from ICMR, from any other organization. You can mention your financial help from here. Then the material, you are using some LIMOYs or something like chemicals, so you can mention you have taken this help from where. Then intellectual help, scientific advice, review of draft paper, data collection, participation in trials, technical help. So all type of things can be included in the acknowledgement section. Then the relationship that might pose a conflict of interest. If there is any conflict of interest, that could be mentioned here also. Next. Then the references. References allow readers to locate source material. So they can find out what type of work has been done in the past and how to approach there. If the general name is there, property, volume number is there, page number is there, so anybody can go and search out and find out the paper. So allow readers to locate source material. It should be accurate, current and complete. You have to try to avoid the very old references. Try to give the references that are very recent and they should be correct and they should be complete. Don't give the incomplete references. That doesn't give you a good picture. Not too many or not too few references. And reference section look for the point size. There is a different point size for the different section. Different point size for the result and material method and introduction section. So look for the point size. It should be in some less than the earlier point size. Usually 0.9 and that comes under 12 or 10. Then journal article, books, chapters and books. This is a different style. Suppose you are writing a journal article, the writing reference pattern is different. You are writing a book, chapter in books, that is a different website and follow a uniform and prescribed pattern for writing the reference. This is a different pattern, suppose. Mukhopadhyay A, Ramakrishna B.S. So pattern will be like this. It will not be A Mukhopadhyay or B.S. Ramakrishna, J. Khan. This will not be a good sequence. Sequence will be first surname, then author name. A, Ramakrishna B.S. Khan G. And there will be no end. In certain journals, after six names, there will be atal, followed by atal. So they are not going to give 8 or 9 or 10 numbers. After six names, there will be atal. Then there is a title. Then this is name of the journal, Indian Journal of Medical Research. This is year 1999. Then this is volume number 109. It will be in italic. Then there are these research page numbers. Page numbers 85 to to 9. 9 means 89. So if 8 has come once, it will not be repeated again. 85 to 9. This is for a manual. So manual is the name of the manual in Italy. And it will be given like this. World Health Organization, WHO recommended surveillance standards. This will be given like this and in Italy. This is a newspaper article, how it will be written. This is a book. Book will be in Italy. The publisher, where it was published, Boston, and the name of the publisher. Book will be in Italy, place New York, and this is the publisher Academic Press. Then here. This is the style of writing, the difference. This is a different pattern. Article typing. Article typing is the most read part of the paper. It introduces the readers, it generates interest of the reader, and avoid two general or illustrated styles. It is important term at beginning of the title. So title should be very crispy, it should be very attractive, or it should be very clear. Only the reader will try to give the view if this is a very good article, a good title. Yes. Then authorship. Author can be a single, author can be multi, author can be an institution. In the early morning, somebody was discussing about corporate author. So corporate author can be an institution. Suppose there is a very vast study and so many people are involved. So an organization can be an author. That is a corporate author. Or an institution can be an author. So single author, it can be a multi author. Author can be an institution. Sometimes seems improbable that a single author can be conceptualized, planned, executed and write a paper all alone. Very rarely all alone a person can write a paper or can do all his study. So there can be a certain working group. Conception. After design of work, analysis and interpretation of data. That can be one group. Second group can be drafting the article, revising it critically for important intellectual content, or final approval of the version to be published. All three conditions must qualify for the authorship. Then there are keywords. Keywords are most important for such analysis. Must be given utmost importance and nothing important left behind. There should not be more than 5 to 6 keywords in every article. After the abstract, there are 5 to 6 keywords, and keywords are very important. Through keywords, you can search the article. Suppose there are keywords like malaria. So if you put a word malaria, all articles related to malaria will come in the same basket. So keywords are very important for search analysis. Frequently use terms in text, titles, and elsewhere. Avoid abbreviations and arrange in alphabetical order. These are the keywords, certain keywords, gender equity, human welfare, indicators, unemployment, work participation. So these are the keywords which I have taken from the article published in a journal of medical research, poverty and health issue. So these are the article. So these are the keywords, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 keywords are there, and they are very important in the subject. Yes. There is a committee on publication ethics. Guidelines on good publication practice. So it was founded in 1997 and it is supposed to address on the issues redundant means duplicate publication. So you should be well aware that you are not going to duplicate your paper. Plagiarism means that you are not copying, you are not cheating, you are that should avoid. Then you are not duplicating data. Change in the authorship pattern. Then ethical problems. Just undisclosed conflict of interest. In submitted manuscript or in published article. So there is a committee to take care of all these problems. So you must be aware about these things when you are writing your paper. Next. The science of scientific writing. If the reader is to guess what the writer means, the writer must understand what the reader needs. So that should be the message in your mind. Writing with the reader in mind, expectation and context. Suppose you have data like this. There are certain values and they are written in this manner. Can you understand what is this? Nobody can understand. So there should be a certain pattern. This is a time, this is a temperature. It's given in a proper way. That is the way of presentation. Information is generated more easily and more uniformly if it is placed where most readers expect to find it. So that is most important. Next. Then title, authors and affiliation. This is the view of a paper. This is the Indian Journal of Medical Research. This is the title. Seroepidemiology of poliovirus antibody of children in Eastern Turkey. This is the title. Then there will be author's name. If female lady is the author, then try not to abbreviate the name of the kissing female. Because it doesn't look a good. Suppose Sarah Vansivik, Anshuman Gunskin, Herbert Elia, and Annie Berian. You can't if they are male author, you can have a gay. But if it's a female author, for example, D. Srivastava. D. Srivastava, nobody will understand who is D. Srivastava. If you want to write the name, write Divya Srivastava. So female name should not be abbreviated. It doesn't give good look. Then association, affiliation. I have given this estate. Estate means what? Estate means that this person is associated with the department of microbiology. And nothing is given on the others. It means that others are associated with the department of public health and microbiology. This person belongs to microbiology in Atlantic University School of Medicine, Turkey. So this is the way of writing affiliation. Then this is the paper received when. Next. This is the format of the original paper. The original paper will consist of, this is the short title. Short title will be the first author name et al. First author surname only. Vensilic et al. This is the first author surname. Then this is in italic, this is in caption.